this episode of MiShift Garage, the Trike Strikes Back.
Yeah, I know, I love ice cream.
Cookie dough is the white girl flavor of ice cream.
I eat so much cookie dough though. Although Culver's has a salted caramel cookie dough that is very good.
Oh, that's
I know it's
super
about
yummy.
As basic bitch as it gets, but it's so
I
good.
I think I know where we're going for lunch today.
You're right. Hell yeah, I'd totally be on board. Totally.
We could, all right.
Yeah, we could eat some ice cream. What's up, guys? This is the Road to Powercruise video series. So, welcome. We've got 3 weeks until the best event of the year. It is our Christmas.
It is, and it's Powercruise. We do have coverage from last year if you want to check that out. Yeah. Get an idea of what we're preparing for. But we need to get the pit cruisers revamped, re-engineered.
There's a few improvements.
The Legacy needs a little bit of love. And then this guy, which is my 86 E30, which just needs some little things so it can handle more abuse at the track.
Exactly. So all that and then maybe a little bit extra. We'll see how much time we have left. So thank you very much for joining us. Let's get into this thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, I love it.
So first step, open up the chest. First step with the E30 is to get a roof rack and the basket on it.
Yep. Gotta be able to haul the trike down to Powercruise.
Hell yes.
So that's the point of this.
And we're gonna do that right now?
Yep.
Ka-chow.
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 I light you, McQueen. Ka-chow. We just like toss them on, right?
Yeah, man. You just kind of throw it at the car and they do what they're supposed to.
What are you doing?
Hey!
I'm doing this.
What are you doing?
I'm doing that. Right.
Can you be taking your nap?
You got that side done.
We went swimming today.
You went swimming?
Why's broken?
Because it's old.
Same reason Jake's broken?
Exactly.
No way, man. I'm the new hotness. You're old and busted.
Oh, you can be throwing Men in Black references at me.
Cool. That's gonna be perfect.
Hey, you wanna be up in the basket? You wanna sit up here? We won't go nowhere. We'll just put you in it.
Get fired up for us?
I can't if I can remember which switch this was.
I think we need to redo the mixture.
Yeah, it stinks a little bit.
Yep, what you think, man?
I think it's time to fix it so I can actually enjoy it.
Hell yeah. Let's do this. Let's mount it up there.
Yes. She looks right at home up there.
Find a way to secure it down.
was at the last Power Cruise. We had too much.
Well, we could just show them.
Should we show them or should we tell them?
All right, kick to the video.
That sucks so much. What's your thoughts, Donnie?
I don't have any thoughts right now.
Yeah.
I have nothing funny to say. What happened to your suit?
How can you after this happens?
I have my shit to work.
Well, we got.
Well, they say bad things happen in three. This is my third bad thing for the week.
That means it's done.
Should be. All right, then I'm driving your car.
Kiss my ass.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So as you guys can see, it was quite the failure we ran into. We didn't have PVC sleeves on the back of it yet, so it put all that pressure on the front of it every time we tried to turn it, and well,
twisted the frame.
Yeah. The one piece of original tricycle is like from here to like here, or so,
and
somewhere.
And twisted here.
And it twisted right there. So. What we're gonna have to do is do some bracing. We might end up doing like some tubes coming down here, or a tube, or something like that. We gotta figure that out right now.
So that's our next step. We're gonna strip this thing down a little bit and
reinforce it. Yeah, a little bit of stripping it down, as little as we can possibly do. All right, let's start by straightening the neck out. She's still a little tweaked.
It's not super heavy.
No, it's a lot lighter than the drift cooler.
Oh, I actually got a little gangster lane. Not too bad.
Yep. Yeah, because if we say go up into here. Okay, cool. So let's bend up a piece of tube real quick here and fit it in there.
Awesome.
Now we play the can we get this to bed nicely game. Fairly well welded up. I think we are going to look at this guy. And so the issues on this thing had to do with the steering and the brakes. Go figure. So on the front end of it, there's a little pitman arm that's down at the bottom of the steering shaft, and or steering arm, whatever you want to call it. And first time around, we did a bolt through it. The bolt had a hole that was a little bit bigger than the bolt that we put in it, because it had to be, because it wasn't drilled correctly the first time. So then it got tack welded, and the first big corner that I took at Powercruise, or actually I think it was the first time that I went up on two wheels and I was sliding it around, cue flashback, it broke, and the weld broke loose, and then it ended up really sloppy. So what I did was I shaved that down, re-welded it a bigger, not just a tack, but there's actually a fairly decent sized weld on that now. So that's good. Now we gotta address the brakes back here. So what's happening is the brake in this arm and everything is actually being twisted forward. You can see it has a tiny bit of wiggle to it. And that's because they're only bolted here and here. And you know, like you've got braking force that's trying to stop you and the weight of yourself and the weight of this thing, and it's just pulling it forward. So no matter what, we can't tighten this enough for it to stay put. So what we're gonna have to do is, we've got bolts here that hold the bearing carriers. We're just gonna take and weld on at least one like arm that's gonna attach from the top-ish of this thing, this rear hoop, and it's just gonna use one of these bolts, and it'll just kind of hold it so that momentum moving forward, twisting on it, is just gonna be sort of carried into this bolt up here. So that should keep it sturdy, hopefully. What was actually happening is this was flexing so much that this whole caliper bracket was hitting the axle and was locking. And then all of a sudden I'd come to a screeching halt where the whole thing would just, you know, start skidding. So we'll get that figured out, and then we gotta re-bleed the brakes because that needs it. So. All right, man, let's grind away some fresh powder coat. Calibrated eyeball. Scott, can't kill it.
Oh, yeah.
Crazy turn of events, we actually managed to get everything done on our checklist.
Yeah, which is extremely rare for us.
That is so rare. We got the frame done on that thing. It's not acting all weird.
No, it's nice and tight finally. It doesn't want
to
twist.
You got to ride it.
Exactly. It kind of turns, but it kind of turns and doesn't break. So that's
right.
It's more than it did last time.
You know, and that's just the nature of having a solid axle in the back. I mean, kind of live and learn for us in building. Tricycles, it's hard to do with a solid axle on the back. So this thing, we got the brake figured out, so now the rear end stays put, and so that should work out pretty good.
And the steering is tightened up on that now.
Steering is way tighter now, so all that's left is the throttle, the brakes.
Yep.
Brakes on that thing.
A couple of electrical things to tighten up.
And splash some paint in a few places, and then we're done with the pit cruisers. Then we get to move on to some cars. So thank you for joining us in the first of this series, and we're gonna see you guys on the next one.
Yep.
Have a good night.
Does not
hold it still.
Yep.
Okay.